everybody. We've got relationship expert Bela Gandhi here with more on this topic. Before you go introducing your man to your family at Thanksgiving, there's some things we should consider, correct?
There's a lot you should consider.
And I just said introducing my man, like I've got a man. For women out there looking to introduce their man.
In case you want Mike P. to come to your family Thanksgiving.
For anyone out there looking for a man, these tips are for you.
Okay, gotcha.
Okay, so what's the number one? We have a whole list, right?
We do have a list.
Okay, so it's, you're not excited to meet your family, if they're not excited to meet their your family and friends.
Yeah, if he doesn't want to meet your people, right, through the holidays, number one, I'd say, is he married? Like, what is this person hiding? If they don't want to be around your friends, they don't want to be part of your life. And you have to ask yourself, do you want this person to meet your friends and family? If you feel like they're going to judge you or they're going to judge him and say this is not the right person for you, there's a whole lot going on.
So
here.
I always put on a hat of being the guy, having to defend themselves in these situations. What if they don't get along with the family or friends? What if that's a situation?
That's bad.
That is a situation.
Is that also a problem then as well?
That's a situation. And I would have to say to the guy at that point, is this really what you want to do for your life? If you're not getting along with these people when you're dating, just wait till you're married. Just wait till you got three kids.
She's saying, get out while there's still time.
Get your Nikes on and run.
Okay, so number two, you have a list of things to change about them. So if you've got a lot of stuff that, you just don't like.
Yeah, I mean, if you're already, if this is a new person that you're dating, and you already are like, I don't like his teeth, I don't like the way he dresses, I don't like the way he talks, this is probably not the person for you. If this is the first 3 months, that's as good as it's going to get.
What if it's just one of those things, though?
Look, if it's just something like teeth, for example, teeth are fixable. Don't throw someone back to the pond.
But are they? Really? They are fixable.
So for things like that, you can't fix character.
Absolutely.
Okay, that you can't fix. All the other stuff, clothes, teeth, that's all fine. But if you're already like,
But women feel like they can fix it. It's a rookie mistake. Women feel like they can fix it, though.
Right.
Women always want to fix the problem, I think, is kind of sometimes.
I think it's human to, like, want to fix a problem. Like, you just want it all to work, right?
women are much more attuned to the things that are not right.
Okay.
Right? And they see him right away and they're like, oh, okay, at 1 month I'm gonna tell him this, and at 2 months I'm gonna start to buy him a new wardrobe.
And now this next one, Bela, is one that always irks me when I see it happen to one of my girlfriends, see them with a guy and they're not the same person. They can't be themselves around that new person. That's a problem.
That's a big deal. I've seen this a lot where you're out with your new man and suddenly you're really quiet. You know, you feel like you have to walk around eggshells. Maybe behind closed doors, you're getting a lot of criticism. He's like, I don't like this. I don't like your friends. I don't like the way you look. So you just shut down. Yeah. No, that is a problem.
Yeah, I think it's a real sign that it's right when you can really be yourself.
Oh, yeah. I mean, a good relationship should be one word. Even from the beginning, it should be easy.
Totally.
And if you cannot be yourself, that is not easy.
Yeah.
That's hard.
I feel like that's the best compliment you can give somebody is you've never seemed happier. You seem so much like yourself and so at ease.
Exactly. And like you guys just fit. Yeah. It works. It's good.
So here's the last sign that he's not the one. If you cannot resolve conflicts well.
Can you imagine if you can't resolve conflicts well? First of all, in the first couple of months dating, then you have the stress of the holidays. You know, maybe a crazy uncle at Thanksgiving. And if you and this person can't, if you can't resolve your conflicts easily, imagine what that's going to do. If this person is volatile, hurls lots of criticisms and insults, throws stuff around, he throws the microwave at you when he's mad, game over.
Sure.
The microwave is a for sure game over.
Right. Other things are fine, but the microwave. Wait, forget it.
What's probably the biggest one on here where you're like, that's going to be the biggest issue? Is it not excited to meet family, friends, list of things to change, can't be yourself, or the final one you just mentioned, can't resolve conflicts? Which one should be the golden rule of the four?
The real doozy.
Yeah. I'm looking at all of them
as deal breakers. If I had to pick one for the long term, because we're talking about how do you know if this is the person for you, can't resolve conflicts well.
Yeah.
And if you can't be yourself, like these are all tied together, right?
Yeah,
you
almost
can't separate one from the other. But yeah, no, that's a great question. Like if you feel these things, guys, in your gut, if your gut is churning, every time I ask someone a question, did you know that there were all these red flags? Never once have I heard someone go, no, I was just blindsided. They're like, no, I knew from the beginning. So if you're feeling that, like, this is just not right. I have had people tell me that they knew when they were about to walk down the aisle that this was a giant mistake. Don't do that.
Bella, I'll tell you what, you make me want to be a better man. You really do. Every time this segment ends. All right, well, make sure you check out smartdatingacademy.com for more tips and info from Bella, because she's always dropping knowledge. We love having you in on Wednesdays. We're going to get you in here more often. So much fun.
Thanks,
when we come back, we're taking a look at what you had to say about today's social media.